I'm Black Crystal.
This is Michelle Henley.
Bunny My Game You.
And we are currently hanging out at OSNYC. My experience as a woman in gaming has been, honestly, I think like most other women, constantly having to prove my gamer card and my nerd card, having to always be better than some of the average guy players, always having to show up, be able to talk the talk and walk the walk.
I'm a little more seasoned, I feel like, than a lot of my friends. But I noticed one thing about being a woman in gaming when Chinatown was where you would go with your coin, you know, when you'd be throwing your bowls, trying to compete with the rest of the guys that were around. But with my personality, I'm very happy to be one of the first girls to punch a hole through the wall and kind of say, you know what, I don't care what you think. I belong here because I said so.
I think women are making waves in the male-dominated space. Women out here are some of the lead and content creators in the space because they're actually good at the game too.
I think often women aren't taken seriously in gaming. And I think on the flip side, women don't take themselves as seriously as they could with gaming. So often, I think if they're interested in a story-driven game or even a mobile game, they don't consider themselves a gamer because they're not hyper-competitive. But that is the case, and I want to bring women into OS so that they can see that there is community and there is diversity, and there's so many different levels to being a gamer.
It's really important to have this representation because it shows to the next generation that there's a place for them, that they're included, that they have a lane, and that they shouldn't be afraid.
So how do you feel women in gaming are changing the male-dominated narrative, and why do you think it's important to have representation in these communities?
Well, what I think women in gaming is changing as far as the narrative is concerned is just the ability to show that as long as you can be inclusive, gaming can evolve. I believe that the same thing happened with sports when we decided that we were going to have a WNBA instead of just an NBA. And it just opened up all these avenues to where the sport can go. Same with esports and gaming. It just opens up the narrative to see, well, you know what? You know, Bunny My Game You was telling me she really loves strong leads, but the majority of the leads be redhead. She was like, yo, they be redhead with the brunette, you know? And I say all of that to say, in my lingo, it's important to include so that everything that you guys are enjoying about gaming and esports as it stands can evolve and be so much better.
I think, especially with the rise of esports, we are seeing more and more women kind of come forward with their skills and their passion with gaming. I think it is so important, especially in 2020, to create a space that's inclusive and diverse and that represents the broad spectrum of players that are out there. We can't look at gamers as one specific type of person, because, I mean, like, literally every kind of individual makes up the gaming industry.
You were just down south working with ESPN, right?
Yes, I was.
Talk about that. Talk about your experience.
It was really awesome. I got this huge opportunity to work with ESPN and their collegiate esports league. They worked with Blizzard and along with a little bit of Capcom, Street Fighter, to put together this college league grand finals tournament. I did some hosting as well as assistant production, so being in front of and behind the camera. And I think my experience there was super awesome because I got to see the layers and the steps that it takes to kind of create this world and create this space.
Shout out to Black Crystal, Party Up, shout out to Sun Z Bay. So the three of us were really excited to be able to make it out to BET Weekend for the award show and the festival, to which we were a part of the Unanimous Games kiosk. So we got to chill, they had an installment. They invited myself, Black Crystal, and Sun Z Bay over with the Lost Rings Records just to represent and be able to take part in a really amazing installment for kids primarily, but it was just so inclusive. You saw kids, their parents, a lot of influencers were there, but it was a really great opportunity to be able to show up, show out. We were playing Mortal Kombat. I got dropped 1,000 times. Ask Crystal about it. It wasn't cute. But we played Smash Brothers. We had a great time. And it was an ability, it was something that, like, I never felt like we had the ability to do that as girls on the block before. We always used to have to fight to just get in the door. But with Unanimous Games and being at BET Weekend for the festival, for the experience, for the first time, I felt like, yeah, that's what we're doing. We're breaking these stereotypes and lending a hand to those that kind of otherwise wouldn't have been invited in the room, you know?
Nice.
Give me your top three artists you like to listen to while playing video games.
Oh, man.
Doja Cat. That's my favorite girl. All
right, you got to name two more. I said three.
You know, I'm a weirdo. I like to listen to old school, real old school shit.
Top three.
When I'm playing video games?
Like, what you listened to yesterday, kind of shit.
Oh, my gosh. Okay, so I like me some Roddy Ricch.
I'll play 36 Chambers. Anything Wu-Tang.
The Wu.
Especially when you want to loot and shoot.
Definitely it's Kei Chenada when I'm vibes and when I'm grinding. Y'all be bumping Kei Chenada's latest album.
Kendrick. I like me some J. Cole. You know, put me in the vibe to play depending on how I'm feeling that day. But Doja Cat really puts me in my mood. She hypes me up to want to beat you dudes, you know? So that's my girl.
If I'm doing some really cool, chilling story mode, I'm trying to finish Red Dead 2 or something like that, yeah, I'll probably listen to something a little bit smoother. Still old school. I'm a fan. I'm a big fan. I'm corny like that, but I like Janet Jackson. Big fan of Janet.
And then, honestly, my boy Denzel Curry came out with some hot fire
recently.
He just
came out with an album.
Yeah, yo, that recent album, man, that got me pumped every time. I'd be clicking heads with those drops.
This is Black Crystal.
Empress Topaz.
This is Bunny My Game You, and you are now watching Game 7.